Hey everybody, welcome to season 13 episode 4 of Rivals of Waterdeep. Let's go around the table and see all of our players, who they're playing, pronouns, all that good stuff, fun things that they'd like to share. Let's start with LaTia.
It's me. Hi everybody, I'm LaTia Jacquise. I am playing Tahani, everybody's favorite child amusement ride.
This is canon, actually.
I think we're going to work on that branding. We're
It wasn't cleared by Nimrods. It's okay.
Yeah, if you want to be in a music park ride, then you have to specify the park, because if it's like action park or something, you don't want to be in a music
park. It's, I mean, I'm sure it's action, but it's just kind of like every day. I don't know. Everyday park. Arakockra monk, pronouns both hers and mine are she, her.
Yeah, and if you're not, if you're not familiar with Action Park, there's a documentary on Netflix that talks about how awful that park is. And I went there when I grew up, so it's very fun.
Yes, and you survived.
I don't know how, man. next or did he? Is, or did he? Next is Masood.
Hey, everyone. I'm Masood. I play Gazrick Nomrad, everyone's favorite socialist businessman. So Construct Druid. We have a good time, and both our pronouns are he, him.
Every week I keep waiting for the construct, and sometimes I get it, sometimes I don't.
Yeah,
because it just flows, like it has to flow into that.
Often it goes right after socialist, but today I was like, we're rolling on the die. We'll find out where we land.
Spinner? Do you just spin? And
my brain is just a giant spinner wheel. I'm very lucky. It lands on the right word most of the time. Yeah.
It just gets stuck between two choices. That's
where that I think going. Your brain just crit fit.
Right on the line.
That was very well done.
All right. Brian.
Hi, I'm Brian. I play Virgil, your Aasimar Storm Sorcerer. Virgil's pronouns are he, him, and mine are he, they.
Eugenio.
Hi, everybody. I'm Eugenio. I'm GM Jazzy Hens. I'm playing Kent, our phantom rogue tiefling, and both of our pronouns are he, him.
And Tanya.
I'm Astorio, your ranger paladin with just a hand of barbarian. And pronouns, what?
As a treat.
Just a treat. A soupçon of barbarian.
A zest, barbarian zest on the top.
A garnish.
I'm going to make fun of all of your classes.
Please do. This is my favorite game. This is now my favorite game.
We'll talk. I forgot, where was I before you said I had a soupçon?
Touch a barbarian.
This.
If you do the Salt Bay thing, I'm going to reach the screen. I was waiting for the pinch of salt. Okay, it's only 2-hour flight from Chicago.
Anyway,
I pronouns she, her, both of us. That's it. That's where I was trying to go.
That whole thing was a masterpiece. Like, it was Masood trying to like very slowly eating the potato chip or whatever it was, and then
it's an apple.
It did look like a potato chip. I thought it was one too. Okay.
I was waiting for a very dramatic slow crunch there. Like,
I'm classier than to like be a nuisance to any of our listeners who have trouble hearing chewing sounds. So I mute myself.
It was a very slow, like Drax, like eating of a potato chip. It's very good. I'm Shareef, trying to ignore Masood right now. DM, he, him, also the person who did not try to Google soupçon to see what that meant. Also play a variety of NPCs, including Shaka, Tiefling Warlock, also he, him as well. Cool. So, Eugenio, why don't you share with our folks some of our Patreon facts
Yeah, we're not going to go over all of them every week because you all should check it out. But we do want to keep reminding you that we are updating our Patreon and putting some new fun things in for folks who are upgrading or brand new, or even if you've been around for a while. So just a reminder, stuff like a weekly 20 to 35 minute after show with the cast. We talk about what happened. We talk about what is coming. We do all of that fun stuff. We do all that fun stuff. So that's available at the, I'm frantically trying to open the Patreon because I don't remember what pledge tier that comes at. That is at $10 a month. $10 a month or higher, you can get that. If you really feel, we have added a new tier. If you're really excited about the Rivals content and what we can do with even more of your support, I will also mention, that's the $10 a month tier. I'll also mention our top tier, the TMAT Club, which is $50 a month or more, which we know is a lot. So if you can't do it, no worries. But if you can and you want to support us at that level, you do get a ton of cool stuff. You can participate in our monthly AMAs, which are for the cast and the characters. So you can ask all those questions that you don't get to ask at the end of episodes. You, as every tier does, you get access to the episodes early on YouTube and the audio versions. You get bonus episodes, and we do those every couple of months. You get access to Shareef's audio DM journal, and you get quarterly cool merch, t-shirts, stickers, tote bags, mugs with our character art and logo on it. Those get sent to you automatically every 3 months that you are a Tiamat Club patron. So go to patreon.com/rivalsofwaterdeep and check out all of our cool new offerings. If you have thoughts, you know, we'd kind of love to hear them. Let's, you know, we know we're not going to please everybody, but, you know, we're still looking to find ways to expand. So check it out, patreon.com/rivalsofwaterdeep.
Awesome, awesome. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Masood, want to share us up with some ad reads?
Absolutely. Besides our Patreon, we also like to give a thanks to our sponsors that make our game even more awesome and enjoyable for you all, whether you're listening at home, watching it live, or catching it up on YouTube or on our podcast. So we use D&D Beyond for our digital character sheets and access to book content. You can check them out at dndbeyond.com. There's always a legendary bundle happening live when we stream, but you got to be here for it. So podcast listeners, come join us some Sundays. Our dice trays and vaults are provided by Wormwood. You could use Rivals for domestic shipping at wormwoodgaming.com. And we're proud to be sponsored by Die Hard Dice. I'm not even a fan of white. You can check them out at dieharddice.com. Use the code Rivals for 10% off. Thank you. Look at that. And, you know, it's a great set. If you really are feeling so, you can take it someplace and you're trying to play your game and you forgot, oh, no, I don't have a dice tray. Nifty trick. You can take out the mold that all the dice sit in, put this little top sheet back in it. Oh. Boom. You got a little nice dice vault. So, yeah, check them out. Die Hard Dice. If you're looking for geeky gear, you can check out Stormcrow. They've got all this nifty stuff. I would love to get something from them, but unfortunately it's really hard for me to get my hands. Oh, look at that, my mug is back. We've got all kinds of nifty gear and swag over at Stormcrow. Go check them out at shop.stormcrow.com/. And if you use Rivals at checkout, you get an additional 15% off. And if you want to sound oh so silky smooth like the Rivals crew, check out Blue Microphones. You can use crew.bluemic.com/rivals. We get a nice kickback from that, and you get access to some great gear while supporting us. And we love that. We are also now partnered with Idol Champions by Codename Entertainment. We've been there. We know who's there. You can type exclamation point code for this week's free Electrum chest. And don't forget to unlock all the great rivals that are now present, from Selise, Shaka, Tahani, Gazrick, Pest, Disco, Fenris. There's such an assortment and collection of rivals. You got to get them all and maybe see if you can fill out Gazrick's bobble cart while you're at it. We're also now partnered. It's the best thing. Honestly, though, because it gives you gold gain. That's the best part. Like, the access, it does increase your gold gain.
I will say, having you in my formation has gotten me through about 8 levels that I was stuck on before. So thank you, Gazrick.
Yeah, it's wonderful. You know, and we're also, if you're looking for any other games you want to play that involve Waterdeep as a setting, a lore place, you can check out Warriors of Waterdeep. You type exclamation point WoW gems to get free gems in-game every week with our link. If you want to know more, you can also type exclamation point LOS WoW to download and install Warriors on your mobile device. We also give you thanks to our latest sponsor, VoiceMod. If you're looking for that extra step to boost your storytelling, your voiceover work, your GM style, VoiceMod's got it for you. You can use a little bit of post-production effects live while you're playing to add a little modification and a little extra oomph. Some of us are struggling to nail that perfect voice, but VoiceMod gets you even closer while you continue to do it. And I think that's all of our ads for this week, right? Oh, and there's a in the link, Nightbot will get you a chat link for VoiceMod.
Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Thank you for going through all that.
Of course.
Awesome stuff. Now let's hand it over to our whoosh captain, LaTia, to properly set off our recap. Mm-hmm.
I would like to take one more opportunity to mention, we're going to mention this at the end of the show also, but hey, yeah, we're going to be at Gen Con.
Yeah!
That's happening. All of us, except for Brian and Shareef, because they are important people who have other things to do. But we're all going to be there mm-hmm. with some fun little guesty people like mm-hmm. Mark Meir and B-Dick Walters. And yeah, mm-hmm. that's happening. Right. But this whoosh is sponsored by Tiamat.
Ooh.
Because I forgot that I had a little Tiamat on my desk that I could have used for the Tiamat Patreon tier in Shadarble.
Mm. Oh my goodness, yes.
So cute. Yeah.
I love the colors.
She's wonderful.
whoosh.
Yeah, whooshing.
Oh, look, you're about distracted. To pet Tiamat for like 15 minutes.
Sure. Sorry, it's no longer whooshing, we're just petting TMI. Funny. Get your whooshing apparatuses ready, and then use them afterwards to pet your own Tiamat, which is your animal. If you have a dog or a cat or a parrot, give that animal some love.
Nope.
Okay, no, yeah, let's not. No, let's just, no, let's not. Yeah. No, it's not. Yeah, you got it to
the end. Mm-hmm,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
Shut up, both of you.
Love you.
Previously on Rivals of Waterdeep.
Ooh.
Whoosh, whoosh.
I was just going to get up and walk away.
It's the most jointed whoosh I've ever done.
That's pretty messy whoosh, but we still made it through. It's fine. All right, y'all. Let's do a recap of episode 3 for the people last week. So who wants to begin with anything that stuck out with them, affected them, memorable stuff? Who wants to begin?
So we went building to building.
Oh, okay.
Yes, we did. Yeah, yeah. We actually went to that. Oh, well, no, because we had things on the way there.
Yeah.
Yes.
So oh, we yes. stopped off. You're right.
We,
I jumped
first
ahead.
We stopped off to pick up the +1.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, wait, what was Gazrick doing while we were picking up the +1?
Leaving a note.
Oh. That's correct. Okay.
I don't know how I felt so much judgment across the internet right now, but
it's just no one else in the group left a note. No one else in the entire group told Waterdeep we're going to be gone. We're going to be doing stuff.
We don't have to tell the entire city we're going to be gone. Okay, look.
But also, you volunteered for that. You volunteered to stay behind and do that. So we didn't have to.
Why? Was something more important was happening? Was something more? Was a social cue dropped and for whatever reason? I don't understand.
Know what you mean.
I don't know. No, what?
So Gazrick left a note informing the entirety of Waterdeep.
Yes.
All of them.
This was like a group email to everyone.
Just the whole city. Just oh God, what a nightmare listserv.
Just all these message sendings going out from Troll Skull and just like, there you go. Okay.
The bluebirds on the corners are...
All y'all's problems are y'all's problems for the next like night.
Correct. And then we met Faye.
Yeah.
Well, we did.
We did.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about Faye, who this is, and we did.
Not you trying to make what?
I was.
Oh, nothing. I was poking you. You're above me on the overlay, so I was poking you.
Oh, I unmuted. I didn't know if you wanted to talk about Faye.
No, I don't. I want you to.
I mean, anybody can.
I got to sit here and bounce. I can't talk about it, too.
I don't know about any of you. Faye is Selise's girlfriend. And that is why she's been around, what, 60% of the time? Or missing 60% of the time? Mm-hmm. And Kent and Virgil knew about her, but not, they hadn't met her yet. Let's, Dahani. What?
You told LaTia before you told Dahani?
Oh.
I mean, technically, yes.
Yeah, fair enough. Mm.
And poor Gazrick didn't know who this person was.
But on a nat 20, figured it out 2 hours later.
Yeah.
No, you can't say about Gazrick's intuition. Like, he is on top of it eventually.
I'll figure it out. Sure. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Same Gazrick who thought it was okay to eat in the prison bathroom?
Mm-hmm.
I will say, when Gazrick did that, left him alone, though.
True.
Like, if I recall correctly, it wasn't a bad move, just a very weird one.
It's not weird, though, as Gazrick reminds us all the time.
Exactly.
He can trademark that phrase all he wants. It's not going to make it true.
I'd love to put a little TM right after every time I say that.
Yeah, so, yeah, so we met Faye, which was great. This was, like, one of the first, if not the first time we've had, like, a player-controlled NPC, which is pretty cool.
And said player forgot about basically having to talk to herself.
And then everybody headed over to the joke building. Gazrick met them there. What happened when you guys got to the building?
Things weren't quite right.
It was a surprise.
Am I pointing in the right place?
I don't know anymore.
No, you're there.
Yeah, things were weird. There was a small crowd outside, which was great. Very exciting. I'm glad the word is spreading. Very proud of Shaka.
It still looked run down as heck. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Like, well, somebody has to say it.
It's true. And then it wasn't.
Yeah.
So Shaka disappeared into the building, joke building.
Flash of light.
Was gone. Flash of light, gone.
Disappeared.
Very exciting. So after an appropriate amount of D&D adventure terror about a door. We opened the door and went in and went to, now I've forgotten the name of the tavern now.
Well, we had a moment where we weren't sure what was up because going inside was just as broke down as the outside.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, that's right. I forgot. Yes.
We had to go to Table Town.
Yeah, we did. We got hints of things and Dahani twigged it immediately.
Yeah.
You know, she doesn't have to roll Gazrick's 20s to figure something out. And, we eventually went down to Table Town.
Yeah, so the specifics are important because they will come into play. So
God.
You saw,
and so I won't tell you.
So, actually, why it would be as vague as possible, so that you have to step in and fix whatever nonsense we think is going on.
So, like when you went in, you saw a table that was shining. Right. So like everything looked like crap, but this one table was shiny and it looked like it was almost brand new. So like Dahani went and touched it. All of a sudden she was transported over, but to y'all, she just kind of looked like a grayish, misty person. And like as you were in the tavern, you saw this grayish, misty people sitting at tables and stuff. Mm-hmm. And then everybody touched the table. And then we were all at the what you come to find as the Bozen's Tavern. So what happened in the tavern?
He met an owlin who was a bartender.
Yes, something with a J. Shoot,
Javanesh.
That's
awesome name. We kind of the bouncer, like at least treated us like a bouncer. Yeah. Like y'all, what's going on? What are you doing here? Until we said, probably louder than he wanted us to, that we were here to meet Shaka and help.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And then took us to where Shaka was hanging out. Shaka being very casual about, if there was trouble, being very casual about it while engaging in what I now understand is a favored game at the Bow's End Tavern.
Mm-hmm.
What is this game? What occurred?
Officially, it is called Wizard Gizzard.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
But our introduction to it was our beloved, which one was it that was actually playing at that moment?
Maggie was playing.
But we heard our beloved Maggie. I think we asked her, what are you doing? And she said, I'm about to smack that gizzard. And we lost it.
Yes. That's right.
Virgil wanted to know what was going on. Kent wanted to play, you know, like as usual.
That sounds right.
Anything after that?
And then we met.
I think we're all just ruminating on the idea of.
Yeah,
I need to go look it up again because there was like a funnel and then something in it and it smacks out.
Yeah, no, you got to like pull it out the funnel and then like
it's like a funnel that you smack on the top and then this clucking sphere comes out of the funnel and the object is to get it in a bucket that's in about 20 feet away. And Maggie rolled a nat 20.
Yeah, incredible. Yeah,
she did the best that's ever played.
Yeah. And then, so yeah, like essentially, Maggie rolled a nat 20 and took the money. And then Shaka tried to get his money back, but forgot to declare the bet before.
Yeah,
very adequate.
I forgot about that.
Like very adequate play. So it was a no go on getting the money back. And that's when Shaka said, "Okay, let's go talk about stuff," and asked very kindly that Maggie and Tilly not take the entire bar for their winnings. Which perhaps they did. They rolled everybody. It was the color of money up in there. It was just and then we met
I wrote this one down. Wait a minute.
Hulk? No.
Tully. It was Tully. Okay.
I got confused because Tilly and Tully. Yes. We met Tully. We found out some information. We asked more about like strange things, people going missing, problems like that.
Yeah.
And found out that someone specific, a dancer, had gone missing. And our plan was to start to investigate perhaps that person's disappearance.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. It was a character named Larine, who's a sort of a performer. Went disappearing, and they pointed you toward the performing arts area, and that's where we're all heading.
We're gonna check out her like dorm room or locker cubby or like to
try something. Well, exactly. It's a sort of like where like people like prepare for performances, so it's like dressing room.
Gazrick made it weird again because Gazrick was asking for like. Hair or toenail clippings, and
any bit of essence that she might have, you know. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, calling it essence is
it's worse.
That's worse.
Oh, absolutely.
That's worse.
The suit out of character. That is weird.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Great. Yeah, so that is it. Good stuff, y'all. We have made it to the recap.
Yeah,
it was all right, well, John. Thanks, everybody. This is fantastic.
And like also in the chat, if you want to get a picture of Javan, I should put it in there. All right, so let's go into this week's episode. So we are headed, toward this this is a performing arts room. So we're just walking to the room. So we're back in that main hall, right? Where like we saw Shaka, Maggie, and Attili. Also Javanesh kind of like work in the area. Do y'all want to go straight to this performing arts room, or is there anything else you want to do on the way there? It's like not too far. It's like the other side of the, of this main hall.
I just have to maybe like make a perception check just like to look around and like kind of take it all in.
Sure. Yep, good.
Okay. 2 + 5 = 7.
Okay. Yeah. You see a bunch of people eating, drinking. That's about it.
Cool.
Yeah, I think we should just go.
I think so too. The only thing I would keep an eye out for is anybody who is like
showing any sort of particular interest in us or that we are going to this place or anything like that. We are certainly strangers, so like people watching us is fine, but
you can, so like you want to roll to see if anyone's looking in particularly interested in you.
Sure. What do you want for that?
Because you're looking for something specific, you could do an investigation.
Okay, I
can do that. Or a perception if you're not really looking, but something kind of like hits the corner of your eye.
Yeah, Shaka's not told anybody about us outside of perhaps the jokes that are like the versions of us. So yeah, it would be odd if anybody were paying attention. Yeah.
And would you think he does deep enough character descriptions for someone to be like, hey, that's Masood. Right, you know what I mean? Like,
I forgot about that.
Right.
It's not Masood.
I got a 23 on that investigation.
Okay, all right. Elise got a 13 perception. Anybody else roll or good?
Oh, I'll go ahead and.
Yeah, I'll just do a perception. I'm not particularly like.
15.
Oh no.
I'm close to a 20.
Oh. No.
No.
just rolled an 8. Wow.
I kind of want to reroll only because I have the Eye of Vecna dice on.
Oh.
Okay.
Sentence was a joke, and I got real scared before you said dice. Okay,
I actually forgot. I forgot that Beyond shows all the rolls that you're doing. Sorry, look at that. So like I'll say one thing that that Eugenio definitely notices. Uh-huh. And that I'll say that I can't notice this. And that Virgil, I don't think notices independently, but kind of notices, Kent notices, then notices, you know, in like that way, is that Javanesh, who's kind of walking with you, but is sort of like around, is he's the one that's looking around a lot.
Interesting.
So he's like looking at you, but then you see him like surveilling the crowd, like peering really strongly into the crowd, like he's looking for someone specific.
Okay, is it a scan, or has he found who he's pinpointed on
that? He's definitely focused in one area of the crowd.
We don't recognize anybody just like at a quick glance.
It's like a sea of folks. It'd be really hard to pick out anyone.
Well, does anyone stand out? Oh, sorry.
No, go ahead.
Not that.
Mm-hmm. Basically, does anyone stand out to us, or should I roll again?
Not really. What you saw was him looking over there, but if you looked in the direction that he does, you wouldn't really, like I said, it looks like kind of a sea of folks. So you wouldn't see what he's seeing, basically. You know,
my like, non-elfy eyes don't help me.
No, I mean, not.
Oh, did Fae roll perception though?
I forgot about Fae.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, this isn't the challenge.
This is, I was just gonna say, this is wild, because every problem I have as a DM with like party NPCs like this is suddenly a player's problem, and I kind of love it.
Kind of amazing. Like, I need little figures and little notepads to keep track. Yeah. Like, wait.
No. I actually have to do better at mentioning Faye as well when I ask for rolls.
So. All right, I will roll for Faye in a moment. Oh, she has a +7 investigation. I should have had her roll anyway.
While she's rolling, when Javanesh left us earlier, he was just like, I have to go do bar stuff.
Yeah,
right? Like,
exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. So like he's still in the middle of like he's carrying some drinks and stuff, but you see him just surveying around. Okay. So a 15 for Faye. She definitely also notices that Javanesh, you know, is kind of peering around, just like kind of brings that up to the rest of the folks as well. So we can either go to, you know, continue going to the art center or investigate this part further. It's up to you.
I think so. Javanesh is up to something big. Somebody will notice, and we know where to find him later.
If Javanesh is walking with us, then there's definitely going to be an ask where we're getting where we're going. But at this point, if he's checking I don't want to be weird about it.
He's not walking exactly with you, like he's still working, but like he's like in proximity that you could, you know, if you wanted to shout to him or something, like you probably could.
Hold on a second.
I'm inclined to go ahead to the
room
or whatever it is at the moment.
Cool. Yeah. So we're going to the art to the what they call the Performing Arts Center, but it just looks like a room to you. It looks like a room that you change and get ready, right? So like you walk in this door, you open the door. It looks like a nice size room. You know, it's definitely large. Obviously not as big as the main hall, but you know, it's like large enough that you can imagine like an ensemble of folks like a band in here like practicing, or like a dance troupe like practicing dance moves. So like it's a nice size. And then you see about 10 of those gizzards lined up across the wall, along with 10 individual buckets across from them. And that's kind of the only thing that you see in there. Otherwise it's like a pretty, you know, empty room because, you know, it's like there for like people to practice in whatever way that they want to.
Oh, I see.
Did Javanesh come in with us?
No, did not.
Okay, Virgil, now that like we're in and no one is watching us, Virgil's going to cast message back at Javanesh, knowing that he's out there, if he's still within 120 feet.
Yeah.
And Virgil's going to say, hi, this is Virgil. Okay, that part was weird. Who were you looking for out in the crowd, Javanesh?
It's like a salutation.
I was like, do you even know who this is? But you know what? Don't worry about it.
End message, right?
Roger, copy.
You get an unsolicited DM that just says hi.
Oh, no.
Oh, geez. It's just you up?
That's exactly.
Yeah, if you send Javanesh a you up, it might be a whole different relationship.
Virgil's just sending the message.
Okay.
And Javanesh can reply. Basically it's not noticeable. So yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So so you send the message. After you send it, anything anyone want to do like immediately while Virgil sending that message?
I want to look in the buckets.
Okay, cool. So you go through and you look in the buckets, and you notice that some of the buckets, the insides of them are very shiny.
Shiny bucket.
Yeah.
Room.
Like they're shiny in a similar way. Well, I'd say even without a role, you would notice this specifically because you were the one that did this. They're shiny, just like that table was when you first walked into the building, joke building.
That's why he said the details were going to be important.
This is the thing, guys.
Some of these buckets aren't here.
Well, now that's the most confusing possible sentence we could hear. What now, Dahani?
What do you mean?
So we can see?
Well, yeah, you can see them. They're here, but they're not here. They're not here like the table wasn't in the building joke building.
We're going to go to Bucket Town.
Oh, okay.
Wait.
I don't think we can go to Bucket Town. Bucket Town?
I think it's a Bucketsville.
Well, wait a second. If we touched the table and came here, so are they now smacking the gizzards somewhere else?
You
just wanted to say that out loud, didn't you, Virgil?
And in a very deadpan, yes.
Very interesting.
Or maybe these buckets are No, you just, you literally just said that. They're somewhere.
Yeah, like I'm now thinking that we have a bucket synchronized teleportation system going on, which is very disturbing.
I'll toss like a silver piece or something into one of the buckets just to see what happens.
Okay. Are you tossing them, assuming that Tahani has relayed this information to everybody? Are you tossing them into anyone or one of these specific shiny ones?
Actually, you know what I'll do first is toss it into a non-shiny one, just like as a like control group.
Oh, look at the scientific process. Wait,
this is why I was excited about you DMing.
Yeah,
I love it. So if we toss say a piece, I'm assuming it goes in. I can make you roll to get it in.
How far away?
It said toss, but not drop. Okay.
I do not have proficiency in sleight of hand.
Yeah, I say Kent, I feel like would really try to do a dramatic, like not a regular looking toss, like a dramatic looking toss.
He's banking it off of stuff to get. Yeah.
I mean, if he wants, Selise has a decent sleight of hand. If you want her to,
but nothing. So it goes. Nothing happens when it gets in there.
No, it goes in. You know, it makes the noise that you'd expect it to make. You know, right. And right now, one of these buckets. Which ones? So like, there's like a 10 that are lined up in like a row. The ones that have the buckets in them. So sorry, the shyness in the buckets are, if you look at them from like left to right, one is the first one, the fourth one, and the ninth one, the ones that are shinier than those.
Great, I'm gonna do it in the sixth one.
Okay, yeah. Then,
okay,
it's just in there and it's pretty good.
All right, and now let's take it and transfer it to the fourth one, which I think you said was shiny.
Okay, cool. When you throw it in the fourth one, it's gone. Fierce.
You just gave somebody a silver.
Yeah, they're very welcome. All right, well, we're right about this, but what to what end?
Wait, how big is this bucket?
I think the size of like maybe a small potted plant, I'd say.
Small potted plant. Okay. So like too small for like a person to fit in.
You could always try to squeeze into a potted plant.
I cast grasping vine on the ground and create a vine that lassos around my waist and say, all right, I'll be right back. Let's see what happens. And I like try to put one foot into the pot and then a second one.
Oh, I'm terrified.
Yeah.
Okay. This is definitely
just saw the look on Sharif's face. No, very scared.
Well, this is definitely gonna be some rolls for sure, because even though Gazrick is small, this is also very small.
Right.
Okay. So just as a note, Faye pulls a whip out just so she can like be ready just in case.
Seriously, like we're all kind of reaching back for this vine now, like
I'm just saying. This is what people are going off to. This might be how they're like moving them.
I had another question as God was doing that, but
Sorry, go ahead. What's your question?
When the coin disappeared into the fourth bucket, did it appear in any of the other remaining non-shiny buckets?
If you go and I check
look while Gazrick is. While Gazrick is doing his highly dangerous and untested experiment, Virgil's just gonna look in the other buckets to see if the coin happened to appear in one of the non-shiny ones.
You don't see it in any of the non-shiny ones. Gazrick, you can either roll just a straight up strength if you're trying to just like, you know, muscle your way in there. You can roll like a dex or athletics if you're trying to like, you know, deftly squeeze yourself in there.
Oh, it's definitely
dead. Or you can roll a survival.
This
is definitely like a something that could harm you.
I will take survival because I got a plus 11 in it versus my minus 1 in athletics. So Gazrick's ready for any situation. We'll see what happens.
I'm so excited. Mm-hmm.
12 plus 11, 23.
Okay. All right. And you're just trying to put one foot in or both feet in?
I'm starting with one foot. I'm just like, if the grasping vine is more or less there to make sure if it's like if there's newfound gravity for whatever reason, and I'm like gonna be yanked, I want like some counter force. Yeah,
sure. All right, you put 1 foot in there, you put. I was thinking of the.
Thank you. How do you afford?
What's the name of that song? You put your left foot in. You put the hokey pokey. Yeah, the hokey pokey. I cannot think of the name of it. I was like, left foot out, swing all about.
You can teach Oliver that song soon. There's a, you know, he's at the appropriate age for it.
I can teach him right now.
Yeah.
So you put your left foot in.
Yes, this part of the adventure.
Exactly how I played it, everyone. Exactly 100% how I planned it was one of the players sticking their foot in a
bucket.
So your foot goes in. Yeah. You kind of it's going in past how deep this bucket is. Mm-hmm. Your foot is in there, but you essentially imagine like a T position. Where you have 1 foot going out here, body's here.
I can only squat.
And the pot is down here, so you're like T-shaped into the pot.
I'm going to leave this room and go back into the main room.
Okay.
And look at the other wizard gizzard buckets. Do I see Gazrick's foot coming out of any of those buckets?
You see, Shaka, Maggie, and like Tilly are still there. You just see them doing the same thing, just smack when these clicking things are going there. You don't see Gosrick's foot coming out of any of them. Obviously, well, you don't see an obvious foot coming out of it. Also, which bucket did you pick, Gosrick? Was it?
Yeah. Oh, this is a good question.
Was it 1 or 9? Because like 4 already has the thing in it. I mean, you could have still picked that.
I guess I would have done 1, just like the first one, like going through the process. If we're now trying to see what's on the other side,
yeah. All right. Yeah. Cool. So like a 1 and 4 are occupied, 1 by Gosrick's foot,
1 by a silver coin,
and
1 by a coin. So and Gazrick, even though you had a great survival roll,
I hate that.
You're stuck, man.
What?
Yeah.
What? Oh no! Oh no! Yeah. Someone get some butter. All right, we got to figure this out.
Faye just holds up a whip.
Are you okay?
I'm okay. There's nothing underneath my left foot. So I think wherever this thing leads is, nothing's pulling on it. It might be pointing up or it might be in the sky, but I can't really get back out.
Selise?
Yes.
Both of us are like, not really strong enough for this moment.
Can you maybe strong arm Gosrick out of that bucket?
Oh, I've been waiting to do this forever. And Selise, like, he wants her extra stuff to Faye. Like, don't let me have any fun. I have a whip right here. I'm strong. Oh, anyway.
Faye, believe me, this is going to be very fun.
Yeah.
So Selise, like, cracks her knuckles.
Okay.
Goes over. Well, because he's in literally a T pose, right?
Kind of. It's like
yeah, yes, yeah. It's like a side T.
Yeah.
So she like half Nelson's him, so she can get up. I'm not choking you if I
want. Oh no, no, I know. Okay.
And she like is very careful not to touch the actual box. Mm. Is the box close enough to the wall for me to brace a foot?
It's not really close to a wall, but you could try to drag it over to a wall or
the box will move.
The bucket is just the inside. Well, it's like
So his foot is like inside of a bucket, but it's more like his whole leg at this point because he like stepped in and just kind of fell.
All
in
right. There. Well, in that case, I'm just gonna careful to bend at the knees when you have to pick up things.
Right.
And I just. Do a quick squat. I'm like, hold on.
Okay.
All right. Pull him up.
Okay. So like you can do an advantage strength roll since he's like
I got the grasping vine helping, you know.
So is that an athletics?
Just a straight up strength, or if you want to do like one of the strength modifiers, you could pick one.
I'll say this: with grasping vine, I conjure a vine that sprouts from the ground in an unoccupied space. When you cast a spell, you can direct the vine to lash out at a creature, blah blah blah. They must succeed on a dexterity saving throw or be pulled 20 feet towards the vine. So like, yeah, is there any way the vine, well, I guess you already have advantage, but I don't know, is the vine can like provide assistance or like an additional bonus on the roll?
We'll see after.
Well, I was wondering because I've got a really good plus on athletics, or I could do a strength.
You can use athletics if you want.
Okay. Do I still have advantage?
Yes. Yes.
You are so lucky. I have a 21.
Okay. Yeah. So
the DC was 22. No.
Don't even say that. I would just like accidentally like disjoint.
I would love to have this new moment where who's that guy? Prometheus tied on a rock with his liver being picked out. Gazrick stuck in one leg in a bucket. All ceased.
The same. It's definitely the same.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yep.
Gazrick comes out, but his leg doesn't. No, sorry.
No. I'm ready for this. I cast regenerate. I'm ready for this. I have the skill. I prepared it.
Yeah. So
are you serious?
No. Oh. So
I would be horrified both in character and out of character.
No. That is not this. That maybe I'm Black Dice Society. Maybe
Dave, if you're watching, don't get any out of this.
With that role, you're definitely able to pull him out of there. Gazrick, though, you're like the lower part of your leg now is shiny.
Interesting. Can I make a check on that, like Arcana or?
Yeah.
Love to.
Ray is going to do an Arcana check too.
Do we? I got a 14. Interesting.
Yeah, that's a good question. Yeah.
Yes.
Yo, 26 from Faye. Nice.
Very love to see that.
Okay, great. Yeah. I'll say, Gazrick, you look at it. You know, there's something to it. You can't quite put it together though. Faye, though, Faye realizes that one, you know, that you use this to sort of transport from the old building, joke building, into the Bows Inn Tavern. So she figures that this shyness has to be a way to transport somewhere else.
Okay.
In that it like has to be a combination of these buckets.
Oh.
No, it's a puzzle.
Right. So the first bucket. Well, yeah. I'll say with like a 26 that she's able to like put this to together. So the first bucket, one, right? That's the one that Gazrick's leg was in. Four had the piece of silver that like put it. So there's one more bucket that was shiny as well, which was nine. That's not been touched yet or like manipulated yet. So like I'll like say that Faye kind of calls all that out, and everyone's attention is probably peaked at nine is the one that's not been
Can Faye dip one of her whips into it and see how far down it goes?
Yeah, sure.
What
one of her whips is my favorite phrase.
Mm-hmm. she dual wields hellfire whips.
Hell yes.
Yep. Yeah. She puts the whip in, and it goes as far down as she wants to dip it in.
Sorry. She stops above the rim of it, and when she doesn't feel any resistance, she pulls it back out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Whip is shiny.
Hey.
Check out that whip appeal.
And whip it good.
Y'all
You know who.
Now I'm done. All right. It's okay. It's not okay.
The shiny.
Police made a pun. All right.
No, no.
musical reference is not quite the same as a
pun. Oh.
Yeah.
So the shiny that is now exhibited by Gazrick's leg and Faye's whip, like, are we seeing it just as like translucent, like we did?
Yes. Or,
Gazrick, are you all right?
Am I?
Got you eaten.
Yeah. Am I all right? Like, do I feel okay?
Well, one thing that you start to feel, Gazrick, is you feel like someone is pulling on your leg. Like, you feel like there's like someone pulling on your leg. And yeah, this is all one elaborate.
Oh, I would have loved.
I was so ready for you to go there with that. I'm like, mm-hmm.
This is when Shaka busts out and says, "Waka waka waka."
Right.
Yeah, so like you feel like someone is pulling on your leg. Mm-hmm. Faye also feels that someone is pulling on her whip as well.
So Gosrick's Gosrick's leg is fine. Faye's whip that's now shiny. Are we seeing any tension or slack change as we're looking at it?
Yes.
Or does she just it is actively react. Okay.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. You wouldn't feel it on. I mean, you wouldn't see it on Godric's leg because this person is like they're pulling it, but you know you won't see someone's leg move. But like the whip is easy enough to move around, right? Mm-hmm. That like you do see, Faye's whip kind of unnaturally swaying.
Okay,
I have a question that I should have established beforehand.
Yeah,
I
is Shaka here with us?
No.
No, he's in the main room playing Wizard Gizzard with the biddies.
Yes.
Has Virgil heard back from Javanesh?
Just at this point, and I promise it's not because I just remembered. Javanesh comes in the room. And he sees Gazrick with a shiny leg. he sees Faye's whip swaying, and he says, "What did you do?"
We thought for a moment maybe your people who are disappearing were being put through these buckets somehow.
Hey Javanesh, where do these buckets go?
These buckets weren't here when I was in this. I was just in this room, like,
oh, what now?
Like a couple of hours ago.
Okay.
Then I do feel the need to ask why you entered the room asking what we were doing.
I got a message from someone. I didn't really know who it was, but I figured that it must have been one of y'all.
You know,
it's incredible that you've that quickly.
I mean, all it said was "you up," and I wasn't sure.
It did not say "you up."
I think you did say like, "Hey, it's Virgil." So
yeah, I just but the message just asked like who Javanesh was trying to look for in the crowd.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I kind of, I don't know. I don't know how to really use the message thing, so I just wanted to just like come in here personally. But I swear, I just organized this room a couple hours ago, and what the heck is this?
I explained to him what the buckets are doing and how they are.
Okay, great. So like he's like, looks like someone's been using our transportation methods for something else really strange. Oh, what? Gazrick, what is that on your leg?
I don't know. It I thought you would understand. It feels like the magic of whatever's your portal devices use.
But it's not supposed to be on a person.
It shouldn't stick to them when, like, I mean, actually, yeah, we went through the table and we weren't glowy.
Tells me it's because you're not done.
Yeah. everyone do a perception roll on Alex, or like in the immediate vicinity of Gazrick's leg, I should say.
I have no modifier to my perception, like this? Which is why I love rolling it.
I'm also everyone.
Oh, wow. Okay. Great rolls.
Wow. Nice. Okay. I got,
I got an at 20.
Right.
20.
Yeah. No, but it's natural.
Everyone sees, in the same way that when Dahani first transported to Tabletown, you saw kind of a ghostly version of her. You see a very faint ghostly version of a person that's kind of hanging on to Gazrick's leg. With Eugenio's nat 20. Oh my god. I don't know why.
I love it. I love it.
It's great.
It's all good.
But Kent basically looks a little bit closer and can make out some facial details. And he can tell that it looks like a young woman that looks pretty similar to the description that Tully shared of Larine, of the missing child. Because I will, we will retcon a bit and say that that when like Tully was describing it, that Tully showed you like a photo.
Okay.
of this student,
so I'm gonna do my best to first just ask Javanesh. Hey, Javanesh, did you know Larine?
Yeah, I knew Larine very well. It's really a shame that no one's seen her for a while. I mean, we definitely have people that go run off and do weird things, but they always come back. And like Larine, it wasn't really one of the ones that would ever do something strange like that.
It's helpful often for missing persons cases to just get different sort of perspectives of the person so that we aren't biased by one person's opinion. So could you just sort of describe physically Larine for me real quick?
Sure I can. She's
you don't have to, you could just say you do.
Oh man, come on, don't.
Oh, okay, all right, no, do it. Yeah, I love it. Yeah,
don't take this from me.
No, please, by all means.
yeah, and I kind of put her in the chat as well.
Oh, great.
She's you know she has like
she's awesome.
Turquoise hair, olive skin, rimmed glasses that she always wears, even though she doesn't need them. It's kind of interesting. Like, we're at a magical school, like, we would need glasses. And then like he just continues to describe her, and this lines up with with sort of the, even though it's a ghostly image, like you're nat 20, like Kent somehow, you know, can sort of make out these things. So if you had to guess, like you would say that this is slurry.
Last question before I stop monopolizing the screen time. So now I was fine with Javanesh, and then we saw him watching, and now I just don't know. So when he was talking about Larine just now and how it's a shame that she's gone, was that sincere? Does he genuinely seem like sad about it?
You can roll insight, or like anybody can roll insight.
I'm definitely going to roll insight on that.
Rolled an 8, but I'm proficient, so it's a 10, so 16.
Oh, for fuck. sorry.
That's okay. I did one earlier today, too.
Yeah, okay, that's a 9. I have a question about the ghostly figure that we see at Gazrick's leg.
Oh,
eye rolls from Dahani and Faye. I'll say that, like, Dahani and Faye, he seems like his mind is on something else, but it doesn't seem like duplicitous. Like, he seems like he's being honest, but he also seems like he's like, I have a lot of crap to do.
He is still running a tavern while trying to figure out this mystery. Okay.
Yeah.
So did that Nat 20 give me anything for Faye?
Just that Faye is pretty sure that he's telling the truth.
That he isn't the one who took her, which is what I wanted to make sure. Okay, cool. Thank you.
I think
Brian had a question, right?
You
had a question.
Yeah.
So the ghostly, like we can see a ghostly figure pulling like regular size person or like, oh, okay. Yikes.
It's like a person that's like laying on the ground, kind of like pulling on Gazrick's leg.
Okay, it's a little tough on the hip joint. I'll be honest, either I go all the way through or I get the leg back, one or the other.
Well, how are you gonna fit all of you in a bucket?
One at a time, we put the other leg in. Take the other leg out, put the right hand in, take the right hand out, put the left leg in, and then you do my head, and then somehow you have to get my torso. I don't know how the torso happens. Haven't gotten that far. But I wonder also if my body is there and my head is not there, if I move around in that world, will my physical torso here juxtaposedly move around?
Javanesh, is there anyone who can help us with the magic that you use for teleportation so we can maybe figure out the connection between these buckets?
Yeah.
I'm not about to armor Gazrick in a bucket until like, no.
Yeah. I'm kind of like, how'd you get your leg like that? Because like usually we just, you know, embody an object, right? So we say like, okay, this mirror, this table, or this thing, and then people can kind of transport. Like, did someone put that on you?
All I did was put my foot in the bucket. That's it. That bucket, number one.
In the bucket.
You said these buckets were not here when you were here.
They were not here. And I've definitely never heard of anybody putting this stuff in a bucket. It's very, very odd.
Can we just stuff Gazrick in the bucket?
That's what I've been saying.
Not all at once.
We'll make it work.
Yeah. Well, also there's three buckets, right? Because Faye's.
Yeah.
Can we look at, now that we see Larine sort of around my leg, is there any like, can we like intensely look at the whip to see if who's pulling on that one?
I was waiting for somebody to adjust that. Yeah.
There's two things here.
We'll get there eventually. Trust us. Yeah. We'll get there
eventually. What if Faye wraps the whip around Gazrick?
Well, that's the thing that we don't know yet. So I'm interested in this answer because we're not even sure these buckets lead to the same place yet.
That's the thing, right? If Lorene's got a hand on either, then it's great. But
All right.
So what do you want to do? You want to wrap the whip around Gazrick?
We were going to look at the whip closely to see if there appears to be anyone or anything ghostly now pulling at the whip of Faye.
I don't think you have to roll for this since you already noticed Larine. You see all you see is like a hand of like a armored individual that you, it's really, really faint. But I'll let those rolls from like an earlier kind of carry over here. And you see this like a person's a hand just kind of almost like they're trying to take the whip away.
Does Faye feel any pulling?
Oh yeah. It's like not enough that like she would have to resist or like anything, but you see the whip kind of moving side to side.
Idea. I, having looked at Larine and feeling them around me, want to cast scrying on them. Okay. With my leg at like a present in between is like sort of like, if that is the like my bond, my like item. That's my body part. Is my leg in the other part of wherever it is. I would scry using my leg.
That's wild, and I love it.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. You can definitely do that. So like you're trying to get the location.
Yeah, I know my leg. I'm familiar with it. So it's a
cry on your own leg.
Cry on your own leg. Yeah,
okay. It is my leg. So
I like this. Yeah, I like this.
There's they get a minus
your leg
15 to the modifier. My leg gets a minus 15.
Is your leg resisting being found?
Does it get a fraction of your wisdom?
It would be nerve endings in my own like me that would respond back to my brain that I was searching for it.
Oh god. Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, if you're scrying on your leg, it's very funny.
I'm gonna spend the spell slot.
If you want to scry on your leg, the location that you get for your leg is the rest of your body is here. Obviously, you know, right. You're here. The part of your leg that's shiny, though, you're picking up a location, in the building, joke building.
It's in Waterdeep. They're in.
I'm not sure we're in Waterdeep.
No. But they are. They are. My leg is. Leg is back in the building. It's back in the building. I can tell. I know the air. I know the set. It's for sure there.
Okay.
Which means now this person is been moved to our city. Which. Oh, now we are doubly responsible for because it's happening. That means who is the first?
Hey, no, we left a note.
I tried.
Okay, how do we get back to the building, joke building?
Put me through more buckets.
There's got to be another way.
Javanesh, who else has had access to this room?
Well, I mean, I usually try to keep it locked, but it's definitely. There's been so much going on that it's definitely possible that I left it unlocked or something. Yeah. Usually we don't let many people back here except for the people that are, you know, practicing and performing. But we haven't had any performances in the last couple. I mean, I was just here a couple hours ago. In the last couple hours, shouldn't have been anyone in here. I mean, like Tully, of course, could have gotten in here, of course. But out of all the people that work here, I'm really the only one that's sort of in charge of this area. So,
Someone get me a piece of paper and a pen and some string.
I have all of those things on me.
Right there. Yeah.
Ask Larine who did this to her and put it through the bucket and we'd hold on to the string. And then we pull the note back because it will still be in this world. And that way they'll have a pen and paper that will just like, it's like a message between our dimensions, right? If they mirrored each other. If I can feel what's happening here with not the depression of the ink and the force on the paper manifest itself in our reality here.
So I'm
extrapolating. I'm trying, but
yeah. I mean,
yeah. Yes. So as you explained that Javnesh, well, I mean, if you're trying to get back to where you came from, you could just go back out to the patio.
Somebody embody us a portal here or give us like the way back?
I think we just probably have to
see what happens when Gazrick goes back.
Well,
I do a little bit.
Is the leg gonna go like or I
right.
That is where my leg separates actually. Because it matters up in two different locations.
We'll magic it back on. It's fine.
I do have regenerate. Yeah.
I mean the normal way to leave would be there, but this transportation stuff is here for like a reason. I have an idea. Why don't we like you mentioned that these three are the ones that all have the material on them. Why don't we try to occupy these three with something at the same time?
Oh, because the coin fell all the way through. Yeah. This whole time I've been like, well, I thought it was a puzzle about putting things in them, but I forgot about the coin. Yes, Kent is into this and grabs a rope. I think I have a rope.
Babe, you look extremely contemplative right now. What's going on in your brain?
What if we nail the three buckets together and make a trough and then cut out the two connecting pieces? Look, I'm an artificer. It's what I do.
I love this idea. It's so extra. Oh, I love you.
But we don't know if the buckets all go to the same place.
In fact, we have reason to believe that they don't.
Okay. I mean, so my whip then.
Only because.
I mean, I could definitely try it.
But only because the Gazrick's, the basically, it looks like two different beings are trying to reach both Gazrick's leg and your whip. So it feels like perhaps they don't go to the same place.
That's true.
Oh, you're right.
It also might be a little bit like putting a bag of holding inside of another bag of holding, and then we all just get warped into something and die.
Smooth, like the rivals crew. I'll take a rope and do like Faye did with the number four, I think is the one where I toss the coin.
Yeah. So you do that in like a four. I'll say that Javanesh is also has like some sort of rope and he's putting it into nine.
I'll put a rope into one.
Well, isn't Faye's whip
out now?
No, no, no.
Right. No, yeah.
It's out. That's right. Sorry.
I mean, yeah, I could put the whip back.
You could. What about
the person holding on to the whip though?
Oh, that's a good point.
Yeah, exactly. It's just like a ghastly person that looks like they're
so weird. I love
doing it. Science.
So as all three of these are being occupied simultaneously, that needs a name, like the Eugenio Zoom.
It's way harder to do when there's not a camera operator.
It's so good.
Thank you.
Once that happens, everyone is transported into the dingy
everyone
in the room. Yes.
Whoa.
Everyone in the room.
Okay.
Good. It's transported into the dingy BJB. It's a different room than you saw when you first walked in and saw the table when you first walked in. On the ground, you see Larine hanging on to Gosrick's leg. Larine is just basically saying help over and over and over and over again. And then on next to Faye, you see a large person clad in armor holding the whip. Trying to grab the whip as well.
Okay, it's okay. Is Larine or is anyone injured as soon as we arrive? Is anyone like look hurt or?
Larine looks distressed. I wouldn't say physically hurt, but the person in the armor says, "Who are you and how'd you get here?"
Who
are you and how'd you
get
here?
Our question.
Yeah.
Did Javanesh come with us or left behind?
Yeah.
Javanesh is here?
Javanesh is here.
Sorry, Jay, I know you're busy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Wow. Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah.
No, I got nothing other than we could ask you the same.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
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 Yeah. And Faye is just looking at all of you. Like,
somehow we survived to 18th level like this. So.
And it just looks at Selise like, how
Place of the gods.
She just pulls her whip back like, can we just get on with it? You're wasting time.
Are you talking in general or to this?
To this guy who had her whip.
Okay. Yes. Okay. And then he says, oh, I was trying to do this quietly. And then the guard whistles.
Oh no.
And let's everybody roll initiative.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. No. Oh, buddy, buddy, to mess with today. Oh, okay. No. Okay.
Yo, 17. Go. This might be my favorite thing about it
is we look completely incapable. And yet, well,
and
how did you for initiative? I
know. Wow. 16.
How did you?
Oh, oh, sorry, 17.
Five.
Natural 20.
Nice.
A 19. Gazrick 17.
Okay.
Oh boy. All right. Let me just put this in order.
What can I do now?
Goes on my turn, right?
Yes. For Gazrick and Virgil. So both of y'all got 17s. Who has the higher dexterity?
Oh, probably Virgil. I have 10.
I have 13.
Yeah.
Okay. Got it. All right, and then I'm gonna what's up?
I do have, yeah, Virgil. While we're squaring up, and since we're in that weird combat dialogue time, it's like, Javanesh, this answer may or may not become very important. But who were you looking for in the crowd back at Bozen?
Just hold on a second while the DM does He'll be right back in a second. Yeah.
I need my clues. I need my clues.
Yeah. Also, I just rolled a 4 on initiative. So, I'm definitely not ready to rumble right now. I just want to roll for, I'm going to split the guards into 2.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
Bisected or like,
No. Two rounds to attack for the guards. So the left flank and the right flank. Okay.
There are enough people that we are unaware of to split them into 2 groups. I'm not at all worried.
Oh,
yeah. Great. Well, fine. Well, like I just don't want to roll for like that many guards. Right?
Sure. That's worse.
The only question is the building still need to be standing at the end of this fight? Okay.
Yes, that is
or Shaka.
Up to y'all. Okay, so
also don't forget everyone around me has aura of the guardian.
Cool.
Ooh, and cool. Aura of courage, and you can't be frightened.
Nice. Sweet.
Yeah. So like a Javanesh says in like response to the question of like who he was looking for, is I've been working here for a while. I pretty much know or can recognize by face almost everybody that comes in here. And I saw someone that not only did I not recognize, but just I was looking at them, they were looking at me, and it just seemed like it was a bit of a stare off. So I don't quite know who this person is, but I'm definitely going to have to keep my eyes out for them. All right. So we have 10 guards in here, 5 on the left, 5 on the right. Mm-hmm. They don't appear to have any weapons, but they all have armor. And Dahani, you are up.
I have one question before I figure out what I'm going to do with my turn. Does the armor they're wearing look familiar?
Oh, yeah, it just looks like, kind of low to mid-level armor. Mm.
But does it look like Waterdeep guard armor, or does it look like armor that I've never seen before?
Yeah. No, they definitely don't have Waterdeep sigils or anything like that.
Though. Okay, cool. So this is not a crime.
I mean, it's about to be for them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Honey. Looking at,
I don't know what you're talking about. no, the first thing that she's going to do, because this is the first time that we get to use this stuff. She's gonna let out what you think might be a squawk, but it carries the weight of a draconic roar behind it.
Yes.
And she needs them all to make a saving throw as she uses her frightful presence for the first time.
Yeah.
It is not great, the saving throw. It's going to be 8 plus 6. It's going to be 12.
Sorry.
All right. What kind of saving throw is it again?
It is a wisdom saving throw.
Okay, cool. All right. And that is, can that affect all 10?
Yeah, it's okay. Each creature of my choice within 120 feet and aware of me. So it's going to be all of the guards and nobody I consider an ally, which includes Javanesh.
Perfect. Okay.
The girl.
So let's just roll. I'll just roll twice. One for the left people, one for the right people.
I'm so happy we're using the draconic feet.
Okay. Both, all of them fail. They all fail.
Boy.
Yeah.
They
rolled a 5 and an 11.
Amazing. So that was a bonus action. As my action, she's going to puff up her feathers and make herself look really love doing charisma things with this -2 charisma bird.
Yeah.
She's gonna puff up her feathers and try and look bigger than her almost 4-foot self. And she's going to be like, look, we don't have time for this today. Can you just go?
Ah! Okay.
So okay. Funny.
Just do you say it in that way, or is it,
you know, it's incredibly okay. Bored because these five, especially Shaka's not here, these four especially know what Dahani is capable of.
Okay.
So it's kind of a bored thing. Like, I don't want to hit a lot of people today.
Okay.
Specifically today. And I would rather just not.
Okay. Yeah. They definitely look around a bit. They're definitely, some of them do look, there's sort of a door in the back. Some of them do look toward the door. I don't think any of them leave though. Actually, you know, maybe one.
I will say they also, when they are frightened, they cannot willingly move closer to me.
Yes.
So they can't get closer to pretty much any of us right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. So like, they're like a definitely frightened and shaken. They like can't like move close or anything. So they're kind of frozen a bit. All right, cool. Next up is Faye.
Oh boy, Faye in combat. Faye is going to use Banishing Smite on whoever is closest to her. Is it the guy, the armored guy?
They all kind of backed up a bit and they're kind of in this left to right kind of formation. There's like one that would be closest to you, yeah.
Is that one of the other ones that Dahani just frightened? Because she's thinking of like the
main she frightened guy. All of them. Yeah.
She wants to go for like the dude in the armor that sassed them and called for this fight.
Okay, yeah. You would be able to approach them even though they can't approach you. So yeah.
Okay.
You can go up, I'm assuming that's like a melee range, like 5 feet or kind of.
No, it's just it's kind of like a paladin smite. If I hit them, I get to apply it.
Mm. Okay.
Great. So I've got two attacks. I'm using my long sword of life stealing.
Faye has a sword and the whip?
Yes, but I'm using my sword right now.
Okay, got it. Sweet.
Oh boy. One is a 25. One is definitely a 16.
Hits. Nice. The 16 doesn't hit, but the 25 does.
Okay, so because I'm using the sword of life stealing, I get an extra 10 necrotic damage. If they're not a construct or undead.
They are not constructs or undead.
So that's 10 necrotic before I've done anything.
Okay.
My
brain hurts.
Oh, just wait. I haven't done the Banishing Smite at fifth level yet. Mm-hmm. And that is another... That's only eight. That's 18 points total. And Banishing Smite. Next time you hit a creature with weapon attack before the spell ends, your weapon crackles with force, and the attack does an extra 5d10 force damage.
Ooh. Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Yes.
Look, okay.
Yeah.
It's only 20, but it's all force damage. That's 10 necrotic, 20 force, and 8 melee.
Mm-hmm.
On this one dude.
Yeah, and I also see it says if it reduces them to 50 or fewer that they are banished. This does not reduce. Yeah, this does not reduce to 50 or fewer, but that's a cool thing there. Okay, yeah.
Got my hopes up.
No, just add some flavor for the listeners.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So, do you want to describe how you do it, or just go off that damage?
Well, basically, she hits him, and you see the necrotic damage start to, like, kind of seep through whatever you can see of his face. Then when she hits him with the banishing smite, he wavers a little bit, like he's going to vanish, and then he doesn't.
Okay. Wait. Yeah, but he definitely took some damage, so he's definitely, he's still there, but he's definitely, hurt now.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely hurt the main person that whistled. Okay, great. All right, Virgil.
So the person the person who honestly just could have acted like he belonged here and not called for the guards. How's he doing? He's dead, he's gone, he's all okay. Is he still Virgil basically was really hoping that Dahani's thing would work. Because this is like we have a mystery to solve here, and y'all are in the way now. out of his bracers, he pulls out his fan and opens it, and with that waves it at. I guess like he's gonna leave the like I legitimately missed if Faye was attacking the whip guy.
The main person that was there originally that whistled is the one that Faye attacked.
Okay, you know what? He's gonna like attack the hench, essentially. He's gonna throw a chain lightning at one of the hench, and let's see here. It can target four.
Okay.
Four people, and they need to make a dexterity saving throw of 16.
Okay. All right, let's do that. Saving throw of 16. That's four.
If it's a successful save, then they take half damage.
All right. So two of them saved, two of them failed.
Okay. Let me roll damage. That's. Wait, do I have anything else that enhances that? Probably not. I mean, I probably do, but you know what? That is 44 damage for the non-save and 22 lightning damage to those who did save. I'm trying to think. This is fine.
This is fine.
I am. No, you know what? Let's give them a chance to reconsider their life choices.
Okay. God, okay. That would have been rough, though. I think I know what you're thinking of because I think you've used it before, and it would have been fun.
We're gonna do that, and essentially, yeah, like he's not even saying anything. He just like the fan comes out. He kind of snaps it and waves it towards them, and yeah, a lightning bolt arcs towards the first one, and then just hops to the other three.
Pop, pop, pop. Like it. Damn hench. All right. Gazrick.
There's five on the right, five on the left, and they're between us and the exit of this room.
Yes. So far, the main guy got damaged by Fae. Four other ones are currently slightly convulsing from electric shock. Yes.
Cool. Then I'm going to use my action. I'm going to put myself between Larine and these guards, and I'm going to cast Wall of Thorns. And I want to place it like underneath them and like right in front of them, because it's damage when the walls appears is all thing. You create a wall of tough, pliable, tangled brush with needle sharp thorns. You choose to make the wall up to 60 feet long, 10 feet high, and 5 feet thick, or a circle that has 20 feet diameter, blah, blah, blah. I basically, but the wall blocks line of sight. I'm going to create a thick wall of like thorns, basically like around one group, up and over the door, and then around the other group. So like we have a way out unless they can kind of get through it.
I do want to add that they currently can't get close to you because they're frightened, so they can't move really toward you anyway.
Right, which is great. But now they have to go through these vines if they want to follow us out of here, right? Mm-hmm. And I think that would be like kind of the goal. So I'm going to cast a spell if that's cool with my action.
No, not cool.
Not cool.
What do you think you're doing?
Okay. So how much damage do I do with this Wall of Thorns? 7d8 damage when the wall appears. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Yeah, and I'll say that the wall is like, it won't affect everybody.
Yeah.
It'll affect kind of like the like people in the front.
Sure. Right? Absolutely. Yeah, the two definitely if they're like in a line, the two ones up front, but then if they try to get through the wall, they will take 78 damage on their turn. But that is 26 to those two. And then let's see. My bonus actions. No, that's it, because this is a concentration spell. I'm just gonna position myself like in front of Larine and by the group. Yeah.
Okay, great. And just in general, like you go pretty much in front of Larine. Like as soon as y'all came in, she was like on your leg. She was screaming help.
Gotcha. Right?
So she's kind of like not. Doesn't want to get in the thick of things,
basically. Right? I should say they have to make a dex save of 19. On a failed save, they'll take the full 26 on that. Otherwise, they'll take 13.
Only for those two, right?
Yeah, those two. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Let's see. They both fail.
Cool.
They both fail.
Yeah, that's great. I'll just leave. A creature can move through the wall, albeit slowly and painfully. For every 1 foot a creature moves through the wall, it must spend 4 feet of movement. Cool.
Okay. Got it. Awesome. Mm-hmm. So like now, and they don't have line of sight, right?
Yeah, line of sight has been blocked.
Which means you don't have line of sight of them either.
Right.
Right. Okay. Great.
But I think all of our casters have gone, right?
Selise is next. Basically the guards didn't roll well at all.
Yeah.
So all y'all are getting your stuff in before they go.
We tried to warn them. We tried to say.
You tried.
Yeah.
All right, Selise.
This is a silly question. How many arrows can I shoot per attack?
One, I okay, believe.
Never mind.
Yeah. Crossbow or Bobo?
Longbow.
Bobo.
Not Bobo.
I heard it too.
You know what? I can't stand any of you.
Yeah, I believe it's one, unless it specifically says it's like a volley or something in the
description. But you know what? I would like to rage.
Okay.
And Celicia's very calmly unsheathes her sword, rolls her shoulders, and walks up to dude that Faye already whooped on. And
Before you do that, Gazrick has blocked them off, right, with this wall.
Oh, all of them?
I believe so, right?
I think, wasn't that the idea
was to enwrap them all in this wall?
It was kind of like kind of block them off from us. But if there's like ones that we want to leave as like on the way out, I can say that some of them, it was more or less like I just did these two in particular. Like I, instead of doing.
Okay. So,
yeah.
So there's room on the side if Selise wanted to.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, cool. All right. Okay. Sorry, I just want to make that clear.
Okay. Well, in that case, Selise is still going to rage, but I'm going to use my bow and basically kneel down archer pose and fire up two arrows so that they go up and land within that cage.
Love it. Mm-hmm. I love it. Yeah. Let's roll.
Because she's got the very calm, methodical. You know, when somebody doesn't scream and yell when they're mad, they just get very quiet.
Oh, terrifying.
Yeah. You know, it's worse. It's the worst.
The John Wick, you killed my dog. Mm-hmm. That is where we are. Okay, so she still has a plus 13 on this bow, by the way. So I'm going to do two attacks. One I'm going to roll on here, one I'm going to roll on my own dice. Dang it. So 17 hopefully hits something.
Yep, 17 hits.
And the other is a 23.
Hits, yep.
Okay, so first attack. First damage. That's 12 points of damage on the first arrow. And 9 points. So 21 points of damage from her attacks.
Okay. Great. Yeah. So the arrows go up, come right down. And you definitely hear them pierce into these folks. And so far they have been frightened. Now they're caged and now they're getting.
Oh, don't forget, Fenris gets to
get electrified.
Because Fenris is a doggo, he's going to dart in wherever this opening is and attack the first person he sees.
Okay. Yeah, let's do it.
God, how do I roll for Fenris? I forget. Doggo. I guess I just roll an attack roll?
Yeah, that's what I would think is just a regular attack roll or like a unarmed strike roll.
He also gets a Beastmaster bonus from me.
Beastmaster.
Does he get only one or two attacks?
Mark Singer and those. Never
mind. I think he'd only get one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, Fenris. No, that works because it's a plus 3 to my hit, so that's 19. And then I get my proficiency bonus, which is like another, I don't know, plus 2. So 16. Or sorry, 21.
Okay. Oh wow. Okay. Fenris just jumps on this.
It's a 1d6 plus 2 piercing damage for biting.
Sweet. Okay. And like you.
24.
You said like 20. What was the damage from Fenris? You said.
Oh, it's only a 4 damage, but he did.
Oh. Oh, sorry. So,
yeah, okay, gotcha. I struggle with rolling for Fenris. Sorry.
No, it's all good. Yeah, so that's just four points of damage off of one of the people who I'll say is one of the ones that got shocked. One of the henchmen that got shocked by Virgil. So
you got chomped.
Yeah, shocked and chomped. people aren't doing too well. Well, they haven't even gone yet. But now the left flank finally gets to go.
Hey, left flank.
You're doing your best. Yeah.
Guess what? They can't move toward you. They don't have any ranged weapons. Left flank is bouncing. They are leaving out of the door behind them. So they take their full actions and they say, "Yedaddle." So like a 5 of them are out. Kent.
I think Kent is gonna call. I wasn't expecting 5 of them to peace out right before. So Kent is gonna call out to the others because I can't see them from this side of the wall. Just like something vaguely threatening.
Which is
yeah
Look, you did this to me, so
yeah, I'm you're right. I know.
Let's go. Okay.
So, just, you know, arrows from the sky and thorns from the ground. Your friends had the right idea. I don't know what to tell you. And as, oh wait, hold on. I need to see something real quick. As I say that, okay, so what I'm going to do is, no, it's okay, I can still make this work. So what I'm going to do is, like, go to the side of the wall of thorns and, like, peek around and have, like, my rapier in the hand that is visible to them and say that. And as I say it, is the one who whistled to call everyone in here, they're part of right flank? Okay.
Yes.
So yes, I'm looking at them when I say it. And as I say it, like, I can sort of, like, shudders. And some of the words that he speaks come out of his mouth in, like, visible text form. And they're shaped like that chiller font, like that scary, right, like awful. And they float over towards this guard. And I need the guard to make a wisdom saving throw as Kent unwittingly casts dissonant whispers on him.
Ooh, nice. What is the save?
It is a DC 17 wisdom save.
Okay, they fail badly.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So they're gonna take 9 psychic damage, and they have to immediately use their reaction to move their speed away from me.
Okay, yeah. So they move toward the door that the flank just left. So, like, they're still in the room, but they definitely move away.
And for what it's worth, Kent also, like, backs up because words came out of his mouth in visible form. And that's weird.
I love that. You, like, see the words and you freak out and also back up. People back
just, like, back behind the wall and immediately look at Virgil. I was like, is that how magic works? I don't think that was magic. What just happened?
That is great.
Virgil is a little bit surprised, but having heard Kent yell is only a tiny bit shocked, let's be real.
Earth so husbands funny. Of Waterdeep. They're here all week.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So funny. Javanesh is up. So, you know, as I said before, he's a pretty pretty intimidating looking owlin, kind of like burly. He kind of looks around and he looks back at, like, Larine, and, like, remember I mentioned earlier that he like knows her and all that stuff. He really goes, he uses his action to go toward Larine, and to pull her further away from stuff. So kind of move her further back, to the other side of this room from where all the action is. You can hear him, like, asking if, like, she's all right, how she get here, all that kind of stuff. All right, so that's Javanesh. And the right guards, let's see if they can do anything.
Bless them.
These guards suck. Let's see what they can do. Okay, so they have no weapons. The thorns are still up. There is some room on the side, as Gazrick mentioned. So, but they still can't move toward you. Oh, man. They're just gonna, like, yell insults at you all.
But are they magic insults?
They are insults. Some of them almost sound like jokes. They're insults that sound like jokes. So yeah, almost sounds like a version of what you heard Shaka mention. Earlier he mentioned something that he was coming up with that he wasn't sure that he knew what to call, like the 10s or the 11s or the or the 13s. He wasn't quite sure on the name of it. But,
oh no, but, they are trying to roast us. Okay.
But, they are trying to roast you as they also...
I just got it.
Yeah.
Also be... Again, because they can't do anything else, they also move out of the room, including the person that whistled.
That's what I was... Okay, does she get yanked with them?
Oh, no. She's like behind Jaw with
was it Javanesh that grabbed her?
Yes.
Yeah, I blacked out for enough time to think it was a guard. Got it.
Oh, no. they not like grab and like kidnap.
Got it.
So with their leader is leaving?
Yes. Yeah, they can't, turns out Dahani's spells very effective because I chose to make them sort of melee-oriented characters. You can't really do anything when you're when you can't move toward folks. and when there's a wall of thorns anyway.
Virgil is gonna try something if the leader is trying to get away.
Yeah. What do you want to try?
Yeah, Virgil's going to try to lightning lure the leader, ooh, which I realize is going to be very uncomfortable because that pulls them towards us, which they actually aren't allowed to. Oh, that could be gross.
I mean, they can't do themselves, but like you can definitely.
Excellent. Yeah. He's basically going to try and whip a lash of lightning around. It is a. Oh, go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say, can we rule of cool? Like, can I do something alongside the rule of cool?
I wanted to do something with Faye too. So
y'all have kind of free reign as your
what
last.
What were you gonna do
right before we end?
So I was going to, as Virgil lightning lures the head guard back into us, I was going to be there to have him be lightning lured into a stunning strike so that he can't get anywhere.
I was gonna conjure barrage Faye's sword and it creates. So conjure barrage, you throw a non-magic weapon or fire piece of non-magical ammo into the air to create a cone of identical weapons and shoot forward and then disappear. Each creature in a 60-foot cone must succeed on dex saving throw. If they fail, they take 3d8 damage.
Not trying to kill anybody yet. Okay, I said
he's already been super hurt. I think that's I like that idea. If he tries to get away after this, he can be conjure barraged after this.
Yeah,
ready for next episode.
Yeah, it's a strength save of 18.
Don't even worry about the rolls at this point.
Okay,
Like you want a lightning lore. Hani's got a stunning strike, I'm assuming, with the intention to knock this person unconscious or incapacitate them.
Non-lethal damage, incapacitation only.
Yeah, absolutely. Like Virgil, there's no damage in anything. He just summoned something that looks an awful lot like one of Faye's whips, but made out of lightning, and just lashes it around, and the person is yoinked back towards us.
Okay. And Selise, did you want to do the weapon cone thingy?
Oh, that was going to be Faye, but if we're going for non-lethal, I'll wait and see what he does.
Okay. Yeah, so that's where we're going to end the episode. with these completely ineffective... They would actually had some cool melee moves, but unfortunately they were frightened. All 10 of them.
That's
just how it goes.
Exactly.
Yeah, so if you have any questions, make sure to put them in the chat with the word question for our characters only. If you want to ask a character or in-person question, that's a Patreon thing. And while you're putting questions in the chat, let's go to our outros. Let's go in reverse order. So let's start with Tanya.
Oh, I'm doing a lot this week. Tuesday, I am doing part two of the Let's Get Proud mini campaign for Mini Games International. So 4 p.m. Pacific, be over there. They left off with a Moonstone Dragon that had knocked out the entire party. Oh. And by the way, Kent made a cameo and was their quest giver. So So yeah, they may survive the Moonstone Dragon, or it may be a very short episode and a half series. I don't know. Black Dice Society is back. We got we had a happy ending to what we were trying to do. And then I feel like I'm doing other stuff, but follow me on Twitter, other socials. Everything is Cypher of Tears, CYPHEROFTYR.
Okay, awesome. Eugenio.
Hey, everybody. I'm Eugenio. You can follow me on Twitter and Twitch, not or, choose both, at DM Jazzy Hands. What's going on this week? Today's Sunday. Tuesday, I will be streaming as normal. The schedule's been weird this Pride Month. I've been away a lot, but I will be back to full-time streaming this week. So Tuesday, as usual. Thursday, I'm extending my stream a little bit, so we're going to go 2 to 7 Eastern. And I'm doing a fundraiser for the Trans Empowerment Project as nice. Part of my Pride celebration. So I'm working with Soft Giving, really cool organization. We're trying to, I got a big goal this time, y'all. It's big for me. It's like twice what I've ever made, but we're going to try for it. So I'm trying to raise $1,500 for the Trans Empowerment Project, because as many of us are aware, it's Pride, so yay, but also we got to look out for our trans siblings. So come hang out. I go live at 2 Eastern, and we're going to be raising money for the whole time. There's going to be giveaways and raffles and weird reward stuff if we hit certain donation levels. So it's going to be a good time. So come check that out on Thursday. And I think that's me for the week.
Awesome. Brian.
Yes. Hi, I am Brian, Urban Bohemian, pretty much everywhere on the internet. Sorry, my brain just locked up there for a moment. It is a relatively it's a relatively quiet week for me. I always have to like flip over and check my calendar, like, wait, what's going on this weekend? It's a relatively quiet week. I'll be streaming on my own channel on Tuesday and Saturday, and then this coming Saturday afternoon, I'm going to be part of the Twitch prod that Team Transtopia is doing to benefit Glisten. The plan is that I will be opening it up with a lovely brunch, because it's Pride. Mm-hmm. And keep an eye out on my socials for that. But otherwise, Urban Bohemian everywhere. And then next Sunday, you'll catch me back with these folks.
Okay. Masood.
Hey, everyone. I'm Masood. You can find me on Instagram and Twitter at Maroodboy, M-A-H-R-U-D-E-B-O-I. I'm here on Sundays with these wonderful folks playing Rivals of Waterdeep. I'm over on Wednesday nights doing Stool Pigeons over on the I Need Diverse Games channel. That's really what I've got going on right now. I've got some shows coming up in Chicago in a little bit. So if you're in the area, I will tell you a little bit more about those as they pop up. But yeah, that's me.
Okay, great. LaTia.
Hello. Again, it's quiet for me. I will have something to announce this week, I think. But I just would like to say that, I mean, I've already said that I'm going to be at San Diego Comic-Con. So if you're going to be at San Diego Comic-Con, you should come and say hi to me. Other than that, that's it. I will see you next Sunday.
Awesome. And I'm Shareef. You can check me out, ShareefJackson.com, S-H-A-R-E-E-F, Jackson.com, and Shareef Jackson on all social networks as well. Don't have anything coming up right now. But definitely enjoying planning and rewriting the episodes for this season, which is I honestly always love changing things, like, based on what y'all like gravitate to and mm-hmm. don't gravitate to. It's like one of the fun parts of DMing to me is the adaptability of it.
It better be if you're gonna DM us.
Gazrick stepping in the bucket.
Well, actually, we'll talk about that in the after show.
That is after show content. All right. So I see one question for the guards. Question for the guards. Do you think your roasts were any good? Yeah. So the right flank, you know, they were roasting. One guy says, which I don't know if you knew that I was a cook, but I do make a pretty good, pretty mean pot roast, actually. And then like the other one says, well, I don't mean to call the pot black, or is it called the kettle black?
Oh God.
And yeah, and then they're just kind of going back and forth, trying to add on to each other's jokes, and but these are roasts to them because they're joking about someone's roasts. They think they're good.
They took the theme and ran with it. Okay.
They did. You know what? Points for that.
Yeah. That's right. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. That's it. So if you're thinking the Gars, do they think their jokes are any good? Yes.
Yeah.
They're tremendous.
We heard them as you were running away.
Yeah. That was a very, very effective strategy. Question for Kent. How do you reading your own lips?
Wow, that's pretty funny. I mean, look, I have been getting people to do what I want by shouting at them for many years now. So, you know, getting to see a physical manifestation of it working is really gratifying now that it's not terrifying.
It's still kind of terrifying.
It's a little terrifying, and I really probably should be careful when I yell for you in the future.
I feel like you're going to be, like, wasting your spell spots just... passing distant whispers to no one just to
there are a few other spells currently on the list that would be even wilder if they just happened, so I'll have to
Great. And final question for Gazrick. How committed were you to your body in the bucket plan?
100%. I told you it was going to be piecemeal. And then I really, in my head, the idea is like, well, maybe my torso will just sort of be floating around in this reality, which was a kind of a cool image, too.
I did scribble out a little plan that would have happened if you would have tried to either put yourself in one bucket or I think someone actually did mention this as well.
Yeah.
Put the other buckets on, like cover you in buckets.
In the buckets. Exactly.
Yeah.
Faye was going to artifice them into one big bucket.
Yeah, exactly.
Which would have fit. One Gazrick.
So I kind of scribbled out a little issue with him. Okay, great. Well, thank y'all for watching us on episode 4. We'll be back with a halfway point episode 5 next week. Just want to say happy Juneteenth, everybody. I went to a great celebration out here in Newark.
Nice. All yesterday. Of us a very happy Father's Day to you, Shereef.
To you,
happy
Shereef.
Daddy, yes. Shereef.
Yes.
Well, thank you. Yes. But first one, so pretty exciting. I actually got this cool little. I don't know if you can see it. This little Star Trek.
That's awesome.
Yes. Yeah. Exactly. So, pretty cool stuff. Not sponsored.
Not sponsored by Fatherhood.
So we will see y'all next week. We'll be raiding Imperial Girls. Make sure to stay on the Twitch channel to check that out, and have a great rest of your weekend, y'all. Peace.
Bye
everyone.